नमस्ते डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज टू डिजाइन अ वेल्डेड प्लेट गर्डर एज पर द स्पेसिफिकेशंस विच आर मेंशन इन IS 800 2007, दैट इज इंडियन कोड विच इज फॉर रोल्ड स्टील सेक्शंस. सो हियर वी आर इंटरेस्टेड टू डिजाइन अ प्लेट गर्डर विच इज सब्जेक्टेड टू यूनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लोड. सो विल सी वन बाय वन एंड द कंटेंट्स विल बी द डिजाइन forces calculation, then the design of web, design of flange, classification of section, check for bending strength, shear capacity of web, then flange to web connection, end bearing stiffener, check for buckling of stiffeners, check for bearing of stiffeners, likewise so. And lastly we'll go for the end stiffener connection, and if it is asked then for the curtailment of the flange. So before going for the actual design process, we'll see the problem statement. And here we are going to design a welded plate girder without intermediate stiffeners for the following data, where the span of the girder is 30 meters and the UDL which is acting on the particular span is 80 kN per meter. In such a cases, if it is not mentioned, it is useful to calculate the self weight of the plate girder also. So we'll see step by step how to design it. So first step will be to show the given data. Now for Fe410, Fu, Fy which is mentioned over here, then the span of girder as a 30 meter, UDL which is acting as 80 kN per meter, modulus of elasticity E 2 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. Likewise all the parameters which are mentioned over here, and they particularly here epsilon, value of epsilon for web and flange as a 1. As we are using Fe410 steel grade. So here the intensity of UDL as 80 kN per meter. So the self weight we can calculate by using formula W into L divided by 400. Particularly for in this case is W is the total weight which is acting on the into the entire span. So 80 into 30, that is this is the amount of total weight which is acting intensity of UDL into length of the beam. So 80 into 30 into 30, that is span of the girder divided by 400. So this particularly 400 we are utilizing when the girder is with the UDL. Otherwise when the girder is subjected to the point load and UDL, then we'll reduce this factor to the 300. Then the value, the total load which is acting is a 180 kN. So self weight per meter run will be 180 divided by 30, that is a 6 kN per meter. That will be the self weight of the plate girder which is acting our UDL which is acting externally. So the total UDL, now the intensity is 86 kN per meter. So we are assuming it as a 90 kN per meter for our convenience. So the maximum bending moment we can calculate WL square by 8. So here 10125 kN meter is the maximum bending moment at the mid span, and the maximum shear force at the supports that will be WL by 2, and that we are getting it as a 1350 kN. All these values we are getting as a service load. So the factor design parameters will be maximum bending moment after multiplying it with 1.5. It is a 15187.5 kN meter, and the maximum shear force as a 1350 into 1.5, that is a 2025 kN. So after getting this parameter, we can able to calculate the size of web and size of flange, and that is a cross section of the entire web plate girder. Before going to going for that, we'll take a look for the shear force and bending moment diagram. So here the shear force diagram will be like this for the 30 meter span with the UDL which is acting as a 90 into 1.5, that is a 135 kN meter, that which we have considered already. And the mid span, at this mid span, that is 15 meter from the end, the maximum bending moment which is acting as a 15187.5 kN meter. Particularly for our problem, it will be benefited to calculate the bending moment with some intervals. Likewise here, at the span, half span is a 15 meter, I have tried to calculate the bending moment which is acting particularly for 5 meter and 10 meter span, and that will be required while calculating the curtailment of the plate girder. Now here we'll see how to design a web and a flange. So here before going for the depth of the web, we must assume the d by t ratio, that is nothing but the value of k. And here, as the girder is without stiffeners, and that is means only we are end stiffeners we are going to provide if it is needed, otherwise the total span will be without we can say stiffeners that which we are going to provide. So here, as per IS 800/2007, we are assuming value of d by tw ratio, that is a k, as a 120, which should be less than 200 epsilon. And that particular part is mentioned in clause number 8.4.2, page number 59, IS 800/2007. So here, depth of web can be calculated, then that will be the optimum depth of web. D is equal to m k divided by fy. K is nothing but the d by t ratio. Cubic root of this, so it will be the 1938.99 mm, that the depth which we are getting. So we are providing depth as a round figure 2000 mm, so the depth of section will be the depth of web only, the 2000 mm. Then the thickness of web, as we have decided d by tw ratio as a 120, d by tw ratio as a 120, then directly we can calculate the thickness of web. So depth as a 2000 mm divided by 120, that is a key value of k. So tw as a 16.66, which is nearly, we are assuming it as a 20 mm. So for particularly for our design, the depth of web will be 2000 mm and thickness of web will be 20 mm. Here now we know that the total moment which is acting on the section is registered by the flange only. So we'll calculate the area required of the flange to resist the external moment. So it is equal to AF is equal to M gamma M0 divided by FY into D. So in this particular part, all the things are known and the depth is a 2000 mm. So after putting all these value, we are getting area of flange as a 33412.5 mm square. And we can assume the width of flange here for a basic calculation here. So width of flange we are calculating as a 0.3 into depth. So as the depth is 2000, then the width of flange which we are going to provide as a 600 mm, as per the basic relation thumb rule. So here width of flange we are getting it as a 600 mm. So thickness of flange directly we can calculate by dividing the area required, which we have already calculated for the flange. So 33412 divided by 5 divided 0.5 divided by 600. So the value is 55.68, and we are assuming it is nearly equals to 60 mm. And these all parameters which we have calculated, now we'll see in a graphical form how the cross section of girder will look. So here the cross section we are getting as the total depth of web as a 2000 mm, which is mentioned over here, and total depth of section will be 2120 mm, as the thickness of flange is a 60 plus 60. These two flanges, due to these two flanges, we are getting the total depth of the section as a 2120 mm, and here the width of flange as a 600 mm. Now particularly for our problem, we need the distance between these two flanges. So the distance between these two flanges will be the depth of web, that is 2000 plus half of thickness of flange and half of thickness of flange. So here from center the distance is 1030 mm. Now here the classification of section we can calculate by considering the clause 3.7.2, page number 18, as IS 800/2007 here. So here only we are considering the outstanding leg of the flange here. Already we know the d by tw ratio, already we have taken it is less than 200 epsilon as per IS specification. So here we are only going to check the classification of flange. So B is equal to BF minus TW divided by 2. It means total width of flange minus this thickness of web. So B minus TW divided by 2. So B is equal to 600 minus 20 divided by 2, which is now 290 mm. This 600 is nothing but the width of flange and TW is the thickness of web. So B by TW 290 divided by 60. So it is a 4.83, and as per clause mentioned in the IS 800, the BF by TF ratio should be less than 8.4 epsilon, and in this particular case we can say the section which we have provided is a plastic section, and as this section is a plastic, then the value of beta B is a 1. And this particular part is mentioned in 8.2.1.2, page number 54, where they have mentioned for the plastic section the value of beta B as a plastic and compact section, the value of beta B as a 1. Okay, so here we'll check the bending capacity of the section. particularly for our calculation, as per clause number 8.2.1.2, page number 54, we know that the movement capacity of the section can be calculated by MD is equal to beta B ZPX FY divided by gamma M0. Now, to calculate this particular value, that is a movement capacity of the section, we need the section modulus of the calculated section. So our design section is this, which we have shown in the diagram. So for this, now we are interested to calculate the section modulus. So ZPX is equal to 2 into BF into TF. That is two flanges we are having on both the ends, top and bottom. So B into 2 into BF into TF. So, and which are placed at a distance D minus TF divided by 2. So this particular this depth is a 1030 from the center line, 1030 mm from the center line. So directly we have written here 2 into 600 into 60, that is the area of flange. So two flanges are available into 1030, that is the distance at which these are present. So the ZPX, we are getting it as a 74.16 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 3. And directly we can go for the calculation of the moment capacity of the section, that is MD is equal to 16855 kilonewton meter, which is a greater than 15187.5 kilonewton meter. So we can say here that our particular section is capable to bear the external movement which is acting on the particular cross particular plate girder. Now we are interested here to calculate the shear capacity of the web. And here the web is a part which is carries the a total shear force which is acting on the section. So as the thickness as compared to the dimensions of the cross section, the thickness of web is a very small. So here we need to check its critical buckling capacity. So critical buckling capacity, elastic critical buckling capacity, can be calculated by using formula tau CRE is equal to KV pi square E upon 12 in bracket 1 minus mu square into D by TW square. So this particular part is mentioned in the IS 800 2007 clause number 8.4.2.2, page number 59. So particularly for this part, D by TW ratio is nothing but the actual D by TW ratio for our section and not with what we have assumed. So here D by TW is equal to 2000 divided by 20, and that will be 100. And KV as a 5.35, as we are designing here section which doesn't have the intermediate stiffeners. And this particular part we are referring by considering the simple post critical method, by considering simple post critical method, and through which now we are calculating the tau CRE. So all part we are getting in IS 800 2007 page number 59. So here tau CRE, we are getting it as a 96.60 newton per mm square. So after getting it tau CRE, now we need to calculate non-dimensional slender wave slenderness ratio for the shear buckling lambda W. Again, this total formula we can observe in IS 800 2007 IS code. So lambda W, we are getting it as a 1.22, and this value is greater than 1.2. As this value is 1.22 is greater than 1.2, then the shear stress corresponding to the buckling, that we can calculate by using formula tau B is equal to FYW divided by lambda W square into root 3, as the value lambda W is greater than 1.2. So the particularly this buckling stresses, we are getting it as a tau B as a 96.97 newton per mm square. From that we can calculate the web buckling capacity of this section. So here D VCR is equal to D into T into tau B. This tau B is nothing but the critical buckling stresses which are acting in that web section. So VCR is equal to 2000 into 20 into 96.97, and the value is a 3878 kilonewton, which is sufficiently greater than 2025 kilonewton. So we can say here our section that which we have designed is sufficiently taking the external loading in the form of shear force, and that is a 2025 kilonewton. So particularly web which your design is a safe. As we have calculated the cross section and the dimensions we have seen already, so here we'll design the connection between the web and flange. So particularly for this part, we must keep in mind that the two flanges that which are designed, we are going to connect it the two ends of the web. So here particularly at the top and bottom end, we are providing two flanges, whereas the top flange is in compression and the bottom flange is in tension. So when the actual loading acts on the beam, the particularly for the web, the bottom part is try to expand and the top part is try to contract. So in such a case, we are having shearing stresses which are acting at the bottom and top with the same intensity, but the direction will be in the opposite say. So here, while designing this total parameter, we need to keep in mind, we must know the shear stresses which are acting in between these two layers, that is particularly for this part in between this web and flange. So here we are assuming two weld length which we are going to provide from the both the sides. Okay, so here we know this particular formula, Qw is equal to VAF Y bar divided by 2IX, that which are written here. This formula is nothing but the SAY by I that you have might seen in SOM. So here this particular formula we are changing somewhat here. This is divided by 2 because we are going to provide here 2 weld length on both the sides. So the stresses which are acting at this particular layer will be shared by these 2 weld length. So now we are will calculate the moment of inertia IXX for the total entire section, as we are interested to calculate the moment of inertia. So the moment of inertia of total section will be BF into D cube divided by 12. This D cube is nothing but the total depth of the section. So the total depth here we are having, we know the total depth is will be the 2000 plus 60 plus 60, and that will be the total depth of the section, minus we can say the hollow part we are going to minus, that is BF minus TW into D cube divided by 12. This D cube is nothing but the depth of web. So when while calculating this moment of inertia, we'll take a look for the diagram here. The moment of inertia of total part, total section, that which we are going to calculate first, that is 6000 multiplied by 2120 mm, and then we'll subtract this hollow part on both the sides, and that is having depth equals to 2000 mm. Okay, so IXX equals to 6000 into 2120 cube divided by 12 minus 600 minus 20 into 2000 cube divided by 12. So the moment of inertia of the section is 289729.7 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. So from the formula we can calculate the stress intensity here. So VAF Y bar divided by 2IX. So here Qw we are getting it as a 0.418 kilonewton per mm, kilonewton per mm. So particularly for this part, we know as we are going to provide here a fillet weld, so the PdW is equal to LWTT Fu divided by root 3 gamma mw. We know that formula, and when we are changing somewhat here, so we are taking this LW below this PW. So here the PdW divided by LW will be TT Fu divided by root 3 gamma mw. This particular term is called as strength of weld per mm length. This particular term is called as the strength of weld per mm length. This is nothing but this Qw. There is a strength of weld in kilonewton per mm length. So after equating to this, here the unknown part is a TT. So Fu is known, root 3 is known, and gamma mw is known. So here after equating, so 0.418 into 10 to the power 3 equals to 0.7 into S into 410 divided by root 3 into 1.25, considering the shop weld here. So S is equal to 3.15 mm. That is the size of weld which we can provide. But here, the, as we know, the thickness of web is in the we can say the thickness of web as a particularly for our problem it is 20 mm. So we can go with the size of weld as a 5 mm, and that the provide the always whenever we are providing size of weld, that should be greater than the size of weld minimum required. So the minimum value is a 3.15, and the maximum value maximum value related to the web thickness we are going to provide at is S is equal to 5 mm. So this is the part where we have seen how to calculate the cross section for the plate girder, and also we have seen the how to provide the flange to web connection. So particularly we are stopping here for this particular part. In next part we'll see how to design the stiffeners and connection between the stiffeners, and finally the curtailment of the flange. So for this you should refer part 2 of the particular video. Thank you.